So, as you can imagine, to-do list applications come in many shapes and sizes, but sometimes they get labels with pricing, and as you can imagine, it's difficult to differentiate what value you get inside of each one. In today's video, I thought I'd rank the best value to-do list applications. You can get involved in the comments if you disagree or agree with me, but I'm going to be sharing them in four different tiers, and I'm excited to dive into today's video. Before we begin, if you haven't checked out my Medium list of the year yet, it's 50 plus productivity apps recommendations. You can check out in the free article below. But if you're interested in subscribing to Medium for my productivity articles, then you can check the link below that too. So I'm here on Tier Maker. As you can see, I've put it into four categories. This category is a non-existent one. The top one is Take My Money. It's the best value in terms of most features combined into a low pricing or a good value pricing. A decent deal, all very good, all right, and improvement could be needed. So let's start with OmniFocus 3. Now, I am gonna put this one in all right. The main reason is because its pricing is very differentiated compared to other applications. It's got two tier pricing, standard and pro, one at $49.99 and one at $99.99. That's one off. So that's a good deal, I would say, overall, if you're a GTD user, especially because you're gonna pay $100 and you're gonna get a very specialized experience and a very well-built application. But that's only per device. But if you wanted to go on the subscription pricing, it's $99 per year or $9.99 per month. So that's why I'm putting it in all right. It's got quite a lot of sort of pricing. There is an alternative that if you're especially into GTD, Nirvana HQ, I always tend to point people towards because the pricing for their premium and their lifetime is actually very good. And it does follow the same principles, although in my opinion, OmniFocus application is very well built. They actually didn't include Nirvana, but I should have. But as you can imagine, another good, well-valued alternative to OmniFocus. So next up is AnyDo, and I'm gonna put AnyDo in all right again. The main reason behind that is because the application itself, in my opinion, doesn't really have as much features as, say, an application like Todoist or TickTick, yet they still charge at their discounted yearly rate, $36, which I think is a little bit steep. I think if they went for something like sort of $29, that would probably be a good sort of sizing in the market. However, they do have some great calendar abilities, and one thing that they do sort of, well, they should be praised on is the amount of devices they're available on, especially the smart home devices and some of the Chrome extensions and extensions for other applications and browsers. So Zenkit To Do, again, I'm gonna put over in improvement. It's $48 per year, which in my opinion, for an application that offers sort of the same sort of tier experiences as say Todoist and TickTick is much more overpriced. And you know, if AnyDo still have their sort of $72 per year pricing, I'd probably put it in an improvement. Well, Zenkit's obviously building it into their Zenkit suite system. So in, you know, obviously they're offering something more. They do have a good free plan. Some of these do as well, so just note that. But I just think their premium pricing is a little bit too much in my opinion. Okay, so I'm gonna put Moleskine's Actions in decent. Now, the main reason behind this is, whilst it's not necessarily a super advanced to-do list application, it does come with an $11.99 per year pricing, which is sort of like, I would say, a healthy pricing for an application like this. But what's good is you can pay $19.99 if you want access to all three applications, Flow, TimePage, and Moleskine Actions. So you do get a studio of applications for iOS. That's the only limitation really. But what I would say is with Moleskine is they've developed this application really well, paid attention to animations and gestures, and really made the experience very packed whilst making it still fluid and easy to use. Okay, so TickTick, Take My Money. TickTick does such a great job of still retaining its $27.99 pricing per year and still packing in an amazing set of features on an amazing range of devices. This application, in my opinion, is the best value to-do list application on the market. just because what it offers is actually an incredible range of features, including the calendar application in Premium, the sort of narrowing down on the week, also some of the habit tracking on Android, and a couple of other sort of smaller features, like, not smaller features, Kanban being one of them. I just think what they do inside the application to pack it in is a really good job. And I'm still surprised they haven't bumped their pricing to, say, $32, $33 to compete with Todoist, but still have people up for it. And it's an application that I think definitely it deserves that top spot. Okay, so Planny, I'm gonna put in all right. Planny 6 is like this iOS application that very well built. However, it does have a lot of focus on the sort of micro GTD experience. In my opinion, its pricing, which is, I believe, $99 per year, let me just check, is all right. It's reasonable. It's sort of good mid-range pricing. It's not to the lengths of, say, Todoist or TickTick, but it does offer a sort of beefier pricing if you compare it directly to something like TickTick. Obviously, Microsoft To Do is a free application, so I'm going to put it in a pretty decent deal because what you get for the offering is actually a good price. Although you do have to buy into some of the Microsoft ecosystems, and naturally, obviously, if you've got Home or Office, then you're going to get a different experience with certain sort of integrations and plugins. However, I think Microsoft To Do itself does offer itself a good sort of lineup. Again, Google Tasks, for what it does, I'm gonna put it in all right, because whilst it is free, again, obviously it doesn't do as much as Microsoft To Do, so I can't really put it in the same tier, in my opinion, for the value in features. So Todoist goes in decent deal for me. Whilst it's $36 per year, it does a great deal for the pricing, and it's got lovely design, a really well-respected team and philosophy. But in my opinion, if you compare it directly to, say, TickTick, whilst there isn't that sort of, I don't think, that design focus at TickTick, it definitely does give you more value for your buck at TickTick than Todoist. So that's why it's not going in the Take My Money. So next up is Todo. It's got a reasonable pricing. I think I put it inside of, it's $36 per year if you decide to go with their pricing for Skeptic. And it does a nice job in terms of a very visual layout on web. But I think that's what the problem is. Its limitations are to only sort of desktop at the moment, which is such a shame. But it is the application of choice for the YouTubers like Matt Diabella. So very interesting. So AkiFlow, again, these are premium productivity applications I'm talking about here. I'm going to put its pricing in all right. The main reason is because it's $15 per month. And that is high compared to the others. However, I think what it does bring in terms of integrations and consolidation, I think it's definitely warranting that price. And what I'll mention in a minute in terms of compared to Motion and Sensama, I think what it does offer is more value for your money than in comparison with these other tools. So I'm gonna put it in all right. Motion, I'm gonna put an improvement, and Sensama, I'm gonna improvement. Sensama per year, if you go for the $16 per month pricing for the yearly plan, it's $192. So a little bit more, $12 more than AkiFlow. But I think for what you get at AkiFlow, you do get more features and sort of more, I feel like more weightiness in the command prompts, in some of the other stuff, in terms of like the calendar integrations. Feel it's a little bit stronger, just an opinion. I'm a user of Sensama, so, but Sensama, I feel like, in comparison with those three. Motion, priced at $228 per year, so much more sort of priced. I'm still yet to fully check it out. However, in my early opinions of it, it does offer a good deal, but it's much more for a heavy, improved premium market. And I think they should take their pricing down to about $16 per month. However, again, I'm not in charge. These two are gonna shock you. Sorted 3, bang in there. It's got a, I think, I mean, I've checked the pro pricing. I believe it's a one-off payment of $14.99 for the iOS version, if you wanna go exclusive with iOS, and also $24.99 for the Mac version, if you wanna go exclusive with Mac. So if you sort of work it out, $39.98. So I feel like that fairly reasonable for what you actually get. So, you know, I just say that's like, take my money. It's a really good sort of offering with the auto scheduling you get and things like that. And having a Mac and the other version is quite good. Same goes with Things 3. Things 3 does such a good job at a sort of positioning itself in the market because it's a timeless application. Like, yes, you might upgrade to Things 4, and if they do like Things where they do a subscription and they sort of blend whatever pricing you've got into the new subscription model, that might be tougher to understand. But in all, at this snapshot in time, Things 3 is such a great priced application. Many people think, oh my God, $79.98 up front. Wow, that's an expensive application. And it is. But if you compare that over, say, 3 years or 4 years, how long you could be traditionally with an application like this, that is going to be $20 per year, which if you compare it to the others, you get a minimalist, beautiful, personal to-do list application that is stunning for the price of, say, Planny, or even $20 per year. Much cheaper than Todoist. If you get 2 years with Todoist, that's gonna cost you how much it costs in Things 3, and you've got Things 3 forever on license. So what I think is the one-off pricing on Things 3 is really good. Take my money status for me. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comments below what you think. As you can imagine, so many applications on the market, but I thought I'd do a roundup of what I think is best. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. Make sure to check out the Medium article and subscribe if you're brand new here on Keep Productive. Cheerio.